Imagine stepping into your garden only to find it overrun with pesky weeds. Now picture the same space, serene and beautiful, absolutely weed-free. In a world where green thumbs are nurtured and gardens are meticulously cared for, a common adversary often emerges, one that challenges even the most seasoned gardeners. Yes, we're talking about weeds. These uninvited guests make their presence known in our gardens, disrupting the harmony of our carefully planted flowers and vegetables and becoming a constant source of frustration. Now, it's easy to reach for the nearest bottle of chemical herbicide. After all, they promise a quick solution to your weed woes. But have you ever paused to consider the price we pay for this convenience? The harsh reality is that these chemical solutions, while effective, are not without their consequences. Let's delve into this a bit further. First, there's the impact on the environment. When we spray these chemicals, they don't just stay in our gardens. Rain can wash them into our waterways, polluting rivers and oceans and harming the very ecosystems we depend on. Then there's the health of our beloved pets. Our furry friends love to explore our gardens, and in doing so, they can come into contact with these chemicals. This exposure can lead to a range of health issues, from skin irritations to more severe conditions. And let's not forget about us, humans. Children playing on lawns, gardeners tending to their plants, all potentially exposed to these chemicals. Studies have linked long-term exposure to certain herbicides with a variety of health problems. From respiratory issues to certain types of cancers, it's a grim picture, isn't it? But don't lose hope just yet. What if we told you that achieving a weed-free garden doesn't have to come at such a high cost? What if there was a way to banish weeds without resorting to harmful chemicals? A way that is not only effective but also kind to our environment, our pets, and ourselves. In the battle against weeds, it's time to arm ourselves with knowledge and choose a more sustainable path. The use of eco-friendly weed control methods is more than just about having a neat garden. It's about safeguarding our environment and health. Indeed, the stakes are high. Chemical herbicides may offer a quick fix, but at what cost? They seep into our soils, taint our waters, and disrupt the delicate balance of our ecosystems. They are harmful to beneficial insects and wildlife, and can even pose risks to our pets who love frolicking in the garden. But it doesn't stop there. These chemicals can also have adverse effects on human health, with some being linked to serious health conditions. Children who play on lawns treated with these herbicides are particularly vulnerable. And let's not forget about the gardeners themselves, who are often in direct contact with these chemicals. The good news? There are effective, eco-friendly alternatives available. So let's explore these methods and play our part in preserving our planet while enjoying a lush, weed-free garden. Banish weeds from your garden without harming Mother Nature with these eco-friendly methods. First up, we have the boiling water technique. It's as simple as it sounds. You boil water and carefully pour it directly onto the weeds. The heat kills them right down to their roots. This method is perfect for tackling those pesky weeds sprouting up in cracks in your pavement or driveway. Next, let's talk about a homemade concoction that's not for your next barbecue, but for your weed problem. We're talking about a salt and vinegar mix. This DIY weed killer is made from household items you probably already have in your kitchen. Mix a gallon of white vinegar with a cup of table salt and a tablespoon of liquid dish soap. The vinegar and salt work together to dry out the weeds, and the dish soap helps the mixture stick to the leaves. Remember, this solution is non-selective. It will kill or damage any plant it touches, so be sure to apply it carefully. Moving on, we have mulching. Mulch isn't just for making your garden beds look neat and tidy, it also plays a crucial role in suppressing weed growth. By covering the soil with a layer of mulch, you block sunlight from reaching weed seeds, preventing them from sprouting. Straw, wood chips, and even grass clippings can be used as mulch. And as a bonus, organic mulches like these improve the health of your soil as they decompose. Here's a method that's a little more fiery: flame weeding. This involves using a flame weeder, a tool that produces a narrow, hot flame to heat the weeds quickly. You're not looking to turn your weeds into a bonfire. The aim is to burst the plant cells, causing the weeds to wilt and die. Remember, safety first. Always have water nearby when flame weeding. Last, but certainly not least, is the good old-fashioned manual removal. Nothing beats the satisfaction of getting down and dirty in the garden, yanking out those weeds by hand. It's especially effective if you pull out the weeds while they're young, before they've had a chance to spread their seeds. For larger weeds with deep roots, a weeding tool can help you get the whole root out to prevent the weed from growing back. These methods not only get rid of weeds, but do so without harming our environment. Each one offers a safe and effective alternative to chemical herbicides. By choosing to tackle your weed problem the eco-friendly way, you're not only creating a beautiful garden, but also helping to protect the planet. Remember, every little step towards sustainability counts. So why not take that step in your own garden? After all, Mother Nature has done so much for us. It's time we return the favor. Don't just take our word for it, hear from these gardeners who have successfully implemented these methods. Meet Lily, a dedicated homesteader who once battled with relentless dandelions. She swapped her chemical herbicides for a simple boiling water technique and has seen remarkable results. Then there's Tom, an urban gardener who was skeptical initially. He tried the salt and vinegar mix, and to his surprise, the pesky weeds vanished in a matter of days. And let's not forget about Rosa, a community gardener who swears by mulching. She claims that not only did it suppress the weed growth, but it also improved her soil's health. Last but not least, we have Jack, a retired firefighter who took flame weeding to a whole new level. His garden is now a weed-free paradise. These are just a few examples of countless success stories out there. These gardeners are proof that eco-friendly weed control works. It's time to make a change. Let's take a stand against weeds without resorting to harmful chemicals. Instead, let's embrace eco-friendly weed control methods that not only nurture our gardens, but also safeguard our environment, our pets, and our loved ones. Imagine pouring boiling water over stubborn weeds, or mixing up your own homemade weed killer solution with everyday kitchen ingredients. Envision using mulch to suppress weeds naturally, or even introducing a flame weeder into your garden tools. And don't forget the simple satisfaction of pulling out weeds by hand, feeling the soil crumble, and knowing you're doing your bit for a greener future. Each of these methods is a step towards creating a healthier, chemical-free garden. But it's more than that. It's about understanding the impact of our choices and making decisions that protect and preserve our environment. Join the movement towards healthier, chemical-free gardens. For a greener, safer future, start today. Start now.